Dear Muslims, in Surah Al-An'am, Allah explains to us, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. We have sent many nations to prophets, to nations before you. And we have sent upon them punishments and calamities so that they may turn back to us. And then Allah says, and this will be our khutbah for today, فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Three things are mentioned. Memorize these three things, because we are living in a time of punishment. Allah is asking, why, when the punishment came down, did they not humble themselves and turn to us? Why did they not humble themselves in front of us? But instead, their hearts became hard. قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. And shaitan made their deeds seem beautiful to them. Three things are mentioned. Let us be careful that we are not guilty of any of these three things during this plague. Number one, Allah says, when our calamity came down, why didn't they call out to us in humility? تَضَرَّعَ in Arabic means to humble in prayer. تَضَرَّعَ means to beseech in a state of humility. Allah is saying, when the punishment comes down, they should have turned to us. They should have made dua to us. They should have prayed to us in a state of penitence, in a state of tawbah, in a state of humility. But instead, what happened? Instead, what did they do? Their hearts became hard. What does it mean, their hearts became hard? It means they saw sign after sign and they did not pay heed. It means they could see what is happening in front of them, but they ignored the reality. Dear Muslims, are we blind to what is going on? Our lives before this calamity, it looks like a dream. The freedom that we had to walk in public, to meet people, to go to the airports, to travel, the freedom to have family over, our economic success, everything has been taken away. Between morning and afternoon, immediately Allah's power came down. How quickly Allah manifested how weak the creation is. Indeed, we are weak and Allah is Al-Qawi. We are faqir and Allah is Al-Ghani. How quickly Allah demonstrated our technology, our achievements, our advancements mean nothing in front of the might of Allah. How quickly that was demonstrated. Our lives seem like an illusion that we used to live, and we are now living in an alternative reality. We don't even know when that change will come. We don't even know the repercussions of the post-COVID world. We have yet to see what is going to happen. فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Instead of humbling ourselves, mankind, generally speaking, has become hard-hearted. We cannot afford to be hard-hearted. We cannot afford that our hearts become callous. Our hearts are supposed to be soft. And what does the softness of the heart mean? It means we humble ourselves in front of Allah. We recognize that we have committed transgressions and sinned. We recognize that as a society we have failed. We recognize that for too long, too much injustice has been happening too publicly, with no one challenging these injustices. We have to be honest enough in our own lives. Even if society does not see what is going on, at least let us as Muslims repent to Allah, have a soft heart, and then be careful that shaitan does not make our actions seem pleasing to us. What does it mean? وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. It means shaitan deluded them into thinking that their lifestyles were okay, into thinking that they were not a problem. The issue is not within them. Shaitan made them feel arrogant and made them comfortable with their actions, with their sins, with their lifestyles. And then instead of blaming themselves, they blamed other people. So Allah is saying, don't be like that. Don't be like that. Turn to me in penitence and humility. Pray to me with a heart full of repentance. Be careful that your hearts do not become hard. Your heart should be soft. And a softness of the heart means you're spiritually aware. A softness of the heart means you understand what is going on. You understand the precarious situation. You understand death is around us. Everyone amongst us has lost family and friends in this last few months. Everyone amongst us, we know people and we don't know who is going to be next. We don't know who the next person is going to be. And yet still there are people amongst us whose hearts are hard. Still there are people that are not returning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ This is exactly what the hardness of the heart is. What will make us wake up and realize? What will make us return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ We don't want shaitan to make us feel that our lifestyles were okay. Not at all. Every one of us collectively and individually, we need to turn back to Allah. Our lifestyles during this plague, our spirituality during this crisis cannot be the same as it was before this crisis. It is impossible for the mu'min to live through a calamity and not turn back to Allah. How can our prayers not be more? How can our dua not be more spiritual? How can our Quran not be doing more? How is it possible that we see all that is going on and it is not affecting our salah, our dua? Why isn't our charity even more? Let not shaitan come between us and between the repentance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.